Hello, audience. We are going to be asking you four questions. If any of these questions apply to you, stand up. Once you are standing, stay standing. Stand up if you have ever been excluded from a group or felt like you didn't belong just because you are different. Everyone's personality is different. Stand up if you have ever been shouted at for the way you act. Stand up if you have ever been laughed at for the way you speak. And stand up if you know someone who has been excluded, judged, or made fun of for the way they look. Take a look around you. This is to show you that you will never know who has been through discrimination. It can be your teacher, your friend, or your colleague. Be careful with your words and action, because it can cause someone to never be the same. You may sit down.
Discrimination is when someone treats another person or a particular group of people differently just because of their sexuality, age, gender, religion, or race.
An example is when a man and a woman are working the same job, but the woman gets paid less. This is inequality.
We gave a survey to grade 4, grade 5, grade 6, and grade 7 students. And we were not really surprised to find out that 80 students out of 146 didn't know what discrimination was.
Now let's start by flying to China and figure out what discrimination is like there. 其实就是人们在做不好的东西关于别人的时候，人们可以歧视因为他的种族、宗教、性别或者年龄。人们歧视因为他觉得别人跟他不一样。
比如有一个人有更多的钱，可以买更好的东西，但是这不表示他可以歧视别的人。大家可以看看这个图表，在这里有很多红色，对吗？红色是表示没有保护LGBTQ，中国也是红色的，这就告诉我们，如果一个LGBTQ在中国里被歧视了， 国家的法律不能保护他们。可是你可以看看泰国，泰国是蓝色的，蓝色是表示有保护LGBTQ在一些地方。这就告诉我们，如果一个LGBTQ在泰国里被歧视了，国家的法律不能，可以保护他们。在普遍的东南亚，
华人家庭里都有一个长辈会担心的问题。这个问题是，如果一个家庭没有生男孩子，这个家庭就没有人延续这个家的姓氏。比如说， 如果一个家庭只生了一个女孩子和没有生男孩子，这个女孩子结婚了和生了一个孩子，那个孩子不能跟妈妈姓，只能跟爸爸姓。就像我，我姓翁，我叫翁福红，我的爸爸也姓翁，所以我跟我的爸爸姓。
以前中国是一个农业的大国，华人们就觉得生男生比女生好，因为人们觉得男生有更多的力气，他也可以去种田。那是以前的想法，现在人们觉得男生和女生平等了。
对歧视的问题，我们大家都有责任，那我们应该怎么做呢？如果我们看到有个人被歧视了，不应该当事情没有发生，我们大家都应该站出来帮助每一个人。那如果我们自己被歧视了，应该跟信任的大人寻求帮助，这样我们都可以觉得很安全，也觉得我们自己被尊重，也很舒服。
Now that we have seen how discrimination is like in China, I am wondering why people discriminate.
Same. Why do people discriminate? Why do people need to judge that way?
According to APA.org, the human brain naturally puts things in categories to make sense of the world. Young children learn the difference between boys and girls, for instance.
Then why is it a problem?
People keep on discriminating because they're not even aware they're doing it. Some people are in denial and think it's okay to discriminate.
People who discriminate others or people with differences think that people with differences are dangerous. Some people also discriminate because they have the desire to keep low status groups in the same status. And some people discriminate because it makes them see their own group more powerful or more positively. They put people down just to build themselves up.
In our survey, we asked the question, why are people being discriminated against? And we found that the top two answers were...
1. Because they're different. And 2. Because people don't respect them.
Can you imagine someone refusing to give you something for one of your most important days? Well, that did happen for two unlucky women who just wanted a wedding cake from the Oregon Bakery Sweet Cakes. But they weren't given a wedding cake just because they were a lesbian couple.
There was also a time where lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and queer people were ridiculed for being who they are. That was in the 1920s, but much later on in the 1960s, there were finally laws in place to protect the LGBTQ community.
That's true. Some people are also wondering when they'll be allowed to get married and have more rights.
But unfortunately, some places in the world are not making progress. I heard that right now, Brunei had just passed down a law to start stoning LGBTQ people.
However, in the 2000s, some places are making progress, like Thailand. LGBTQ people are finally allowed to get married and have rights. This is one of the biggest triumphs the world has ever accomplished.
What about these days? Does discrimination happen every day?
Yes, of course. Discrimination can happen in our everyday lives, such as getting paid less or being laughed at. According to the feminist e-zine, in the span of 28 years, most people have already experienced discrimination.
Today, in different places of the world, we can be who we really are. But some people still feel like they cannot pride themselves because of their race, their gender, their sexuality, their age, or their race.
But some places in the world have already made laws to restrict discrimination. According to the ABA section of international law, Thailand has restricted discrimination based on nationality, gender, sexuality, age, and race.
The US government used to not allow Asians to become US citizens, but today they are allowed. Discrimination could decrease if we all treat each other equally and become more globally minded.
What about our school, Concordian? What do our students think about diversity?
That's the question we're about to answer. We did a little experiment on 1K3 class. four grade two classes and three grade three classes, which is a total of 138 students. We showed them this picture and asked them to choose which doll was the prettiest.
These dolls are all wearing the same bow, has the same dress. 58 out of 138 students chose number one, which was a lighter skin color. And 55 students chose number two, which was the second lightest one. We noticed that the students were quick to pick and did not spend much time looking at all the choices.
We were very surprised when we got an outlier that chose all the dolls, which was not an option. We believe that this student had a more diverse mindset of what is pretty.
We also think from this experiment, students mostly self-reflected or chose the one that identified most to or to their family members.
As you may know, most students here at Concordian are Thai. So most students here at Concordian do not have much exposure to other races.
Research shows that many Thais believe that people with lighter skin color are more beautiful and healthy. Have you ever realized that even in gas stations and 7-Elevens, there would always have to have skin whitening cream?
We believe that more exposure to diversity helps students become more open-minded about different races. Lastly, diversity is a good thing, because if everyone were to look the same, the world would be extremely boring.
And to prove to you that diversity is a good thing, an activist, a writer, and singer, Maya Angelou, once said, "In diversity, there is beauty and there is strength." By the way, how do we stop discrimination from happening?
Simple! We introduce to you...
How to Train Your Brain!
What's that? A knockoff of How to Train Your Dragon?
Well, not exactly. Here's how you can prevent discrimination from happening. First, you just need to train your own brain. Because when you do that, you can educate others and the cycle continues.
And how do you do that?
You can listen to the ninja. The ninja's job is to tell you not to discriminate. When you're about to exclude someone out of your group, the ninja will pop out like this. And it'll tell you to include and not exclude.
Is that all?
No. The ninja is only there to prevent yourself from discriminating others. But you can raise awareness, like by joining social media hashtags, telling other people about it, having contests with your friends, and so much more.
You can also do much more things, like refusing to go along with discriminatory jokes and opinions, talk to a person who has been through discrimination, encourage diversity and inclusivity, and be a role model, and don't stick to stereotypes.
Oh, I get it. I'm definitely trying this out.
This is the heart. As you may know, the heart is the most crucial and important part of the human body. It produces love and keeps us living in this wonderful world. But many things can ruin our heart, such as discrimination.
Why?
When you're discriminated, it makes you feel like you're useless and invisible, and like you can't do anything in this world.
It'll feel like you keep hearing the single word, can't. It'll be like your head keeps telling you that you can't do this and you can't do that. Research also shows that discrimination can cause chronic stress, anxiety, depression, and even obesity. Because usually when people are sad, they will start to eat and realize they can't stop.
It will feel like your heart is slowly crumbling and it's peeling layer by layer until it's weak and sad. But don't worry, if we are not discriminated against, we can have good feelings. If we are not discriminated against, it feels like you're worthy of having a life, worthy of being a human in this wonderful world.
Oh, okay, so we will keep having positive thoughts and believing in ourselves. Our heart will get stronger layer by layer by layer of protection.
Exactly. It should feel like this, because everyone has a purpose in life, but some people just don't notice it.
Now, can the audience please stand up and repeat after us?
We will fight against discrimination.
And protect the human hearts.